أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله سبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر يا لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الكل دفع زكاة الفطر. Everybody pays زكاة الفطر. If you haven't, let us know. The boxes will be going around. جزاكم الله خير. طب الله من عندكم. It's amazing to see everybody. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. So this is the minimum we can do. الحمد لله جزاكم الله خير for being compliant. جزاكم الله خير for sticking to the rules. Inshallah, we'll wait a few minutes and we will start. Just a reminder of the rules. Two mirrors between guys, alhamdulillah, will look great because we will be live streaming in a minute. Volunteers, ideally, maximum five of the four. So we will need you to please either get into a vehicle or inside the building when we start singing. Because the code is five only on the phone. الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
Thank you. والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكره واصيلا. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. Volunteer, جزاكم الله خير. Maximum 5 on the lot. If we can get the rest of you please in the vehicles. جزاكم الله خير for your help. Inshallah, the salah will start momentarily.
Allah hu akbar, Allah hu akbar, Allah hu akbar. La ilaha illa Allah. Allah hu akbar, Allah hu akbar, wa lillahi الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected brother and sister, inshallah. Basically what we will be doing now, inshallah, we will pray two rakat of Eid. I will give you an idea about how to pray. And please, in case if you are not able to hear me, please link to Open Dar Ad-Dar Foundation on the Facebook. We are broadcasting live. You can see and listen the same thing in case if you are a little bit far from us. We have two rak'at prayer of the Eid, inshallah. Then we will have khutbatul Eid. We will have the khutbah. Now, before I start, just before I start the prayer, in case anyone of you has forgotten to pay zakat al-fitr, please pay it now. Because as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, now, if you do not pay it before the prayer of the Eid, it will not be considered as zakat al-fitr, which basically, it was ordained on us to purify our fasting. So please, this is a special donation box for the Zakat al-Fitr. In case anyone has not yet, please do it before I start prayer. After that, it will be a normal sadaqah. This is number one. Number two, from the bottom of my heart, I thank and on behalf of Ad-Dar Foundation, Jazakum Allahu Khairan,
for being extremely respectful for the rules. جزاكم الله خيرا. Really, we are proud of you. جزاكم الله خيرا. You know, we are in a very exceptional situation and we are allowed to do with the condition of respecting the rules and following the rules. جزاكم الله خيرا. And we hope that every single person of us will keep showing how civilized and educated and wonderful Muslims are. Do your best, please, not to break any kind of the law of the rules till we finish the prayer incomplete and the khutbah. جزاكم الله خيرا. Now, I will pray now the fast reminder. To be honest with you, you are all educated and you have received something in your social media applications. There is some kind of fiqh disputes about the permissibility, if it's possible for you to pray the Eid in the car or not. Now, taking in consideration and respecting every single person with his opinion, now we have two options. When I pray the Eid, those who decided to take the legal opinion that it is allowed, you can pray it because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did pray the nafil or the sunnah on the camel while he was traveling. So we have a very strong, valid opinion that what we are doing is valid, alhamdulillah. In case, for whatever reason, you would like to take with the other reason that there is no need to do it, simply stay with us, do the takbir. After the two rak'at, I will give the khutbah. The khutbah, basically, inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend his blessings upon us. And that's it. When you go home, please pray it at home up to the Salatul Dhuhr. So no problem, no harm, whether you decided to pray with us or you decided not to pray. Both of the opinions are valid, inshallah. Now, Salatul Eid, two rak'at. The first rak'ah, after Takbiratul Ihram, I will be doing the takbir 7 times. And the second rak'ah, you repeat after me, those who decided to pray. When I say Allahu Akbar, it's called Takbiratul Ihram, where I start my prayer. After that, I will keep repeating the takbir 7 times. And I will do my best to do it very slowly so that in case someone is chasing us or, you know, following us on the internet, on the Facebook, to take, you know, the delay in the consideration. Now, the second rak'ah, I will read after that. It's recommended to read Surah, Sabbih Isma Rabbika Al-A'la, Surah Al-A'la. After that, second rak'ah, after takbir al-ihram, 5 takbirat, then a short surah, and the prayer after that is finished. Then we listen to the khutbah inshallah for about 15 minutes, more or less. And may Allah accept from all of you and me and descend his blessings upon us and accept all of our deeds. For jazakum Allahu khayran. As-salatu jami'a bi'idna mawla azza wa jal.
Yalla. الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى
والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى كلا بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر 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 الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم اقسم لنا يا ربنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا، وارحمنا واغفر لنا واهدنا واهد بنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لك الحمد على نعمة الإسلام، لك الحمد على نعمة الإيمان، على نعمة الإيمان، لك الحمد على نعمة العبادة، لك الحمد أن جعلتنا نعرفك يا رب العالمين. أحبتي وأخواني في الإيمان وأخواتي في الإيمان، مبارك لكم العيد. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the Eid from all of us. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him. And he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. Mubarak, Eid Mubarak for all of us. In a few minutes, just let's celebrate the beauty of being Muslims. First message, we should be aware that we have two official Eids, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. We need to pay attention to the fact that we celebrate the Eid after two big major worships. The fact that we are celebrating the Eid now, this Eid, we are celebrating the Eid. We are celebrating the happiness. We should be joyful because Allah has enabled us and bestowed His mercy upon us that we did fast Ramadan. We did not fast Ramadan because we just decided. It's because we are Muslims. And we are Muslims and believers. And the fact that we are believers and Muslims, we decide to say, Ya Allah, we have submitted ourselves to your will. The by definition meaning of Islam is to submit yourself to the will of your Lord. So please let's note that when we celebrate, we are not like other many things. Our celebration is not just a crazy movements. It's not just screaming and shouting. It's not doing anything because I'm happy. No, even our happiness is about, you know, it is within rules that satisfies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, basically, Eid is designed for us to be happy and to spread happiness. To do the gift, for example, what we call the Eidiyat, you know, especially for the children. And in our beautiful Islamic culture, all males in our culture as Muslims, we do give this kind of, you know, financial or the money gifts for the females out of respect. Spreading the love, the greetings, the sweets, the new clothes, all kind of aspects of happiness, basically, we should be doing this. Because of this very exceptional status that we are living, the pandemic, this does not mean that we can't do part of these things. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded us to spread the happiness بِالتَّوْسِعَ عَلَى الْأَهَلِ. You know, this concept, tawsi'a, it's just to spread happiness. One of the most, by the way, we have high technology now. You can send Eidiyya to anyone you would like, even the people at home. Don't say I can't go to the bank, okay? You can send the Eidiyya for your mother 10,000 kilometers, to your sisters, to your brothers. You can do amazing things. Within the house, please do your best to let your kids realize, really, we have happiness. It's not just other, you know, festivals and other feasts for the others. It's full of joy. We have the joy. And I really thank everyone did all kinds of aspects of joyful things. Now,
Prophet Muhammad, let's go back to our basic points.
Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says in a very beautiful hadith, للصائم فرحتان. فرحة يوم فطره وفرحة عند لقاء ربه. That's why I go back to the concept that we are happy because Allah enabled us to do this ibadah. And let's go one step back. من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. The one who did the siyam and the qiyam for the sake of Allah as a believer and احتسابا seeking the ajr from Allah in the day of judgment غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. And basically I think this is the ultimate aim for us. To satisfy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that Allah will be happy from us and to leave this dunya while Allah loves us and we have no problem in our scales except the hasanat. What do we need more than that? And note, how did we start this worship, you know, ritual? We started it with Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allah. What does this mean? Is it a mere phenomenal, just a sound? No. Allah is the greatest. Allah is the greatest. Allah is the greatest. Allah is greater than what? Allah is greater than me. Allah is greater than you. Allah is greater than Ramadan. Allah is greater than the dunya. Allah is greater than your job, your money, your cars, my family, everything. Allah is the greatest. So it's a reminder. Be careful. We were practicing a divine course for 1 month to submit ourselves, to train ourselves how to observe Allah in our life. Why? To keep insisting on putting us on the track that He is there, we are here, we will meet Him at a certain point, and we must be a submissive people, Muslimin. أَنَّأْتِي إِلَى اللَّهِ مُسْلِمِينَ. So by the way, we spend full month of divine practicing course how to be Muslims. So therefore, we should be very happy because of that. We are not just celebrating the fact, wow, nice, the balloons are nice. No. What is much more nice than that? You know, they decided to come. I don't know why. Okay. Maybe they are happy. You know, we feel happy because of we are practicing ourselves, alhamdulillah, to know what does it mean, really, Allahu Akbar. And if you noticed, what did I read? It's the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. سَبِّحِ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْأَعْلَى. Glorify your Lord, الْأَعْلَى, the Most High. الَّذِي خَلَقَ فَسَوَّى وَالَّذِي قَدَّرَ فَهَدَى. The one who created, الَّذِي خَلَقَ فَسَوَّى, and He shaped our shapes. It's all about. Allah is there. I admit. I keep connecting myself with Him, keep reminding myself with the fact that Allah is the greatest and He is the only one who deserves to be worshipped, which is the core point. What is the ultimate goal for Muslims in this dunya? That Allah is satisfied from them, they leave this dunya while Allah is satisfied from them. More than that, we need simply nothing. So therefore, we say Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Eid Mubarak, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, really, to accept from us and to descend His blessings upon every single person of us. And by the end of my khutbah, respected brothers and sisters, please, 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 do your best really to let every single Muslim around you, whom you can reach from your relatives or your friends, to feel happy. Let every one of us really, because you know, maybe you have cars, maybe you have money, the fact that you have time, definitely you have time and cars and money, or otherwise you can't come and listen to me. But not necessarily every single person is as such. Let's do our best to spread happiness with the niyyah, with the intention of satisfying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You feel happy, the others feel happy بإذن المولى عز وجل. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد, يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. In my second simple short khutbah after thanking you, I want to confirm my sincere thanks to you, respected brothers, sisters, brothers and sisters in Islam. Your coming here will show our unity. You're coming here basically, you are supporting the power and the strength of Muslims in this country. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, we are enjoying this kind of freedom of speech and freedom of living our religion. But nevertheless, all over the world, even with the democratic countries, even with the countries with the best constitutions, the law gives you the right. But if you are not united and you don't show your unity and your power, no one will care about your rights. We have to be strong, visible, and as we say in Arabic, تحدث حتى أراك. Speak, talk, so I can see you. No one will see us if we are not here. Your coming here is a message. Your coming here is showing unity, power, and a message for everyone really that we are a significant number. We do count. We are hundreds of thousands. We have thousands of us who are paying millions and billions of tax in this country. And by law, you have rights. Please feel confident. Please show the support for your community. Whenever you hear about anything relates to the facts of uniting Muslims, giving the power, this is very significant. Do it always. May Allah accept from you for the fact that you managed to come. And I repeat my thanks again, wa jazakum Allahu khayran, for respecting the rules, for observing the social distancing in a very high civilized way. We are very proud of you. We are broadcasting what Muslims are doing. Let every person on earth see the reality of Muslims, how educated, how civilized, how wonderful, how merciful, how amazingly they love really to do goodness in this khair. Because the one who has submitted himself to the Lord of this universe will not harm anyone, but on the contrary, he will be the best beneficial person on earth. جزاكم الله خيرا. May Allah accept from you. عيد مبارك. تقبل الله طاعات. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you.